Hi, good evening, church. Welcome back to Lent 10:10. Thank you for joining us the third night of this week. And today we are going to continue our meditation on the Passion of Jesus Christ. And tonight we'll be looking into Jesus' Passion, a modeling servanthood. We'll be reading from the text found in John chapter 13. And that is the only gospel that accounts for the washing of Jesus' disciples' feet. So reading from John chapter 13, verse 1 to 17. Please follow me from the text that's on the screen in front of you and read together with me. Now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come, that he should depart from this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And the supper being ended, the devil, having already put into the hearts of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him, Jesus, knowing that the Father has given all things into his hands, and that he has come from God, and he was going to God, rose from supper and laid aside his garment, took a towel, and girded himself. After that, he poured water into the basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel with which he was girded. Then he came to Simon Peter, and Peter said to him, "Lord, are you washing my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I'm doing you do not understand now, but you will know after this." So Peter said to Jesus, "You shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "If I do not wash you, you have no part with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "He who is bathed needs only to wash his feet, but is completely clean. And you are clean, but not all of you." For he knew who would betray him. Therefore he said, "You are not all clean." So when he had washed their feet, taken his garment, and sat down again, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord. You say, well, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have given you an example that you should do as I have done to you. Most assuredly, I say to you, a servant is not greater than his master, nor is he who is sent greater than he who sent him. If you know these things, blessed are you if you do them." So during Jesus' time, it was, customary for them to wash the feet before eating, especially for this Passover meal. Now, this lowly task is usually a duty of a servant to wash the feet of the guests. A servant, is not greater than his master. But yet Jesus pulled off his garment and took the role of a servant and washed the feet of his disciples. Now, what caused Jesus to do what he did? And could this be an opportunity that Jesus sees to teach us about servanthood? And this is a very humbling act of a master. And Jesus, who has the power in commanding others to serve him, yet he took on the duty of a servant. So when Jesus washed his disciples' feet, everyone was taken by surprise of his act. For so often, we expect those in power to be served by others. Yet Jesus did this counterintuitive example of how we are to serve one another. Now, what can we learn from Jesus' act of washing the feet of the disciples? Firstly, Jesus did it out of love, not because the disciples are worthy. Secondly, Jesus did it out of grace, not because the disciples deserve it. And thirdly, Jesus did it out of unmerited favor, not because the disciples earned it. Now, the leadership that Jesus, modeled here, is first and foremost founded on love. Now, let's ask ourselves this question. Why do we serve? Now, consider for a moment, what does serving mean? If serving means about us, then we are missing the point. Serving is not about our personal advancement, but advancing God's kingdom. And we serve because we want others to know who our God is and experience God's love. So in so doing, we too experience God's love ourselves. As the Bible says in Proverbs, as we refresh others, we ourselves will be refreshed as we serve. But now when it comes to Judas Iscariot's turn, Jesus washed his feet too, even though he knew that Judas is going to betray him and cause him to suffer and die on the cross. Now, this is another very powerful act of love we saw in Jesus. Even though Jesus knew that Judas is the one going to betray him, yet he showered him love even though he is undeserving one. How much are we willing to serve others who have wronged us? And Jesus modeled a very strong act of humility to the point of serving the very people who is going to hurt him. Too many of us here that, we find that this is a very unacceptable expectation to treat those who have wronged us or those who have hurt us. But Jesus has turned, the tide of humility to a very high level. And it does not take away his identity as the teacher and the master. In fact, through this act of humility, Jesus showed us his greatness and his love by his servanthood. And that's why in verse 17 he says, "Now you know these things. God will bless you for doing them." Now there is a very big difference of knowing something and doing something. And he says, "Now that you have seen these examples of Jesus, you will be blessed if you do them." Consider this as a meditation point tonight. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for teaching us the power of humility and servanthood. We saw your greatness through your act of humility in serving others. Lord, we fall short of the mark of humility and we want to seek your help to take away all our pride and arrogant ways. Transform us with the right attitude, that is to serve you and to serve others in the right spirit by honoring and respecting each other in the body of Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, tomorrow we'll be looking into the institution of the Lord's Supper. And I would like you to prepare the ambience as we are going to celebrate, together with your family and friends. So stay on to have some time connecting to one another after this with the reflection questions and to pray for one another. And I will see you tomorrow. Good night.